aging theories. Having approximately 450,000 people aged 85 and older, the Australian Bureau of Statistics in 2014 found that 3.4 million Australians were aged over 65. 65 years and older were projected to outnumber children aged 0 to 14 by the year 2030. This raised serious implications for the maintenance of mental well-being, physical health, quality of life, socioeconomic implications due to low birth rates, increased life expectancy, and an aging population. Developmental theories, I will talk about the different developmental theories that exist in regards to aging. Erikson's stage of psychosocial development posits that aging is a struggle between integrity and despair. Integrity is being able to realize that life has order and purpose, despite the eventual physical and mental decline. Despair, on the other hand, is seeing life as devoid of meaning and being unproductive as a result. Shea and Willis, stage theory of cognition, highlighted elements such as reorganization, in which individuals 60 to 65 years of age started to engage in meaningful intellectual activities after retiring. Reintegration and legacy creation are when people only find knowledge that is functional and meaningful for them. This can involve, sadly, planning for the inevitable, such as arranging for their own funeral, finding a tomb, etc., or could manifest in the form of a life review by writing a memoir, giving an oral account of one's life to grandchildren, etc. Levinson's transition theory is another theory that stresses the importance of aging as a transition in mental and physical ability, as well as in role orientation, because they are retired. It is, however, also depicted by a decline in autonomy and capacity. Additionally, Cohen's human potential stage is said to start in an adult's mid-30s and is characterized by these three elements. They include liberation, which is a desire to engage in activities that may have not been previously possible when they were working. This includes individuals aged 55 to 75. Summing up is another element which usually occurs between ages 60 to 90, and it involves a search for purpose, a need for altruism, and an accumulation of wisdom. Encore, finally, is a reflection of one's life, and it involves a celebration and reaffirmation of the important events in life. It usually spans ages 70 to the end of the lifespan. Psychosocial theories, on the other hand, involve the disengagement theory proposed by the likes of Cumming and Henry. This theory states that the elderly no longer desire to connect with society and thus disengage with it. They are more focused on their own situation, thus withdrawing from the world. Activity theory proposed by Haverhurst stated that the elderly keep themselves busy with leisurely and voluntary activities. Greater activity helps to anchor their lives and to develop a greater self-concept, leading to better life satisfaction and higher morale. Finally, continuity theory posits that the core elements of individuals are retained throughout life. These elements include various patterns of behavior, roles, etc. It also states that choices made early in life can change which activities one chooses to do later on. looking back at all these theories, which one appeals the most to you? A critique to these includes that they are usually very large generalizations. Hence, these are not prescriptions for all elderly, though it may be relevant to the great majority of them. Thanks for watching. If you are interested in my videos, feel free to check out my videos on developmental psychology in the boxes. Thanks. Bye-bye.